Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome to a new video of Triple Grace. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And the topic of this video is stepping on snakes and scorpions. Brothers and sisters, we have talked in many videos that we are called in Luke 10 from 1 to 20. We are called that to walk the path before our Lord, to go into the places and cities that He will visit after us, to be the forerunners of our Lord in His image, to visit these cities. And the Lord has given us authority over all the power of the enemy. That's the reason why I made yesterday that video about the fear, because many of us are still too much in fear of what the enemy can do against us. We need to come out of our church thinking. We need to come out of this spiritual ways only. This is a different time, a different era. And when you move into your destiny and into your purpose and into your missions, then the Lord said, look, I have given you authority over all the power of the enemy, and you can walk among snakes and scorpions and crush them. Nothing will harm you. Brothers and sisters, also we know that this refers to the 144,000. We have a similar pattern for us as the harvest workers. When somebody will send a soldier in a strong battlefield, what will he make sure of? That he has a perfect armor, that he has the best weapon he can find, and that he is mentally completely prepared for that. That he is a strong warrior that will not give in, that will not cave in at the slightest sign of the enemy, but that will stand. You have the power. You can step on snakes and scorpions. You have this power. The Lord is with you all the time. There's nothing to be afraid of. Your destiny is to walk in the darkest valleys. Some of us will go into the dragon lair where we are facing giants and demonic spirits so ugly and so perverted that you cannot even imagine it. You will be in an evil environment in your missions, where you will see evil symbols, where you see everything evil. But you cannot falter. You cannot be overcome, but you have overcome the world, and therefore you will continue on the path in that mission. You will find the lost sheep and you will set them free. The Lord has strengthened you. He has taken you out of the world. He has separated you. He has given you the token into your hand for the purpose, because He knows that you have a warrior heart. And when you have this warrior heart, then there is nothing, absolutely nothing, that the enemy can throw against you that you cannot withstand. Have you not learned from the times in the wilderness that you can overcome all evil? Have you not learned from the times in the fire that you are now stronger and stronger every day? We are just waiting for our Lord and Savior, our bridegroom, to come, and then our destiny will begin. But I'm telling you, I and all the other warriors, do we really want to stand next to a warrior who is filled with fear? Or do we want to stand next to a warrior who has a battle cry of the kingdom of heaven on his lips and is standing strong and say, nothing, nothing can harm me? Because the heavenly armies are next to me, and the power and the glory of the Father, Son and Holy Spirit are on me, and I'm carrying the mantle of light, and I have the sword of fire in my hand. Nothing can harm me. That's what we want in a warrior. Then the enemy cannot breach our army. He cannot breach the wall. He cannot infiltrate us, and he cannot come through. Because you know, no matter what he will try, he will not change your path, and he will not make possible that you run away. You will stand. You will stand on the battlefield. And not only stand, you will advance against the enemy. You will breach his line, and you will enter his places, and you will find the lost sheep, and you will set them free. Look, I have given you authority over all. And that is from Jesus. And when Jesus said he has given you authority over all, then that means all. That means any trick of the enemy. That means anything, no matter, it might come to you, but it will have zero effect on you. Zero effect, I'm telling you. Because you have authority over all. You have to understand this. Jesus, your bridegroom, has given his brides the authority over all. No scheme of the enemy can reach you. You can never be part of New Zion. You cannot be overcome. No symbol of the enemy can ever touch you. Nothing will change your destiny on purpose. You are already sealed. The power of the enemy cannot come against you. Yes, they will. Yes, of course you will see it. Yes, of course, maybe you will feel it, but it will not change anything within you. Because if you do not have this authority over all, you will not be able to walk in the darkest valleys. And you will not be a powerful warrior in the remnant army of New Zion on the battlefields. No matter what your mind is telling you, no matter what you think you are feeling, you have the authority over all. You can rebuke anything in a moment and it will never ever affect you. You are sealed and prepared and selected for this moment in time to be a powerful warrior. This is the time of Luke 10. I'm looking forward with all of you to walk on the battlefield, to stand there, to crush the lines of the enemy, to step forward. Because I am not afraid of anything that is coming. Nothing will harm us. Nothing will injure us. This is a promise of the Lord, of our bridegroom. And as such, it is beyond contestation. Nobody should have any doubts about that. It is coming from God Himself. The power from on high that I have talked about in the last 2 days. No one can take it away from you. But with every power that you have, with every strength that you have, it is a matter of mind. So faith, believe that you have all this authority over all and then nothing can come against you. No matter what it will come for us, it will have zero effect on you. Stand in this power, stand in this strength from on high. This is the authority that Jesus has given you over all the power of the enemy. Now it is time to exercise it and not to run away from it. To exercise it. You are like a powerful wall, like a hedge of protection around you. Nothing. Yes, it will come to you, but what does it have an effect on you? Nothing. Your focus will remain on the kingdom. Your path will be the narrow path. Your fighting will be the same. It does not change you. As it would change somebody who does not have the authority over all. It has zero effect on you. It is only you personally, who can bring this into your mind and you can destroy your authority over all by your own mindset. But the power was given. And therefore, you need to stand strong as a powerful warrior in the remnant army of New Zion for such a time as this. Remember always, when you face situation, when the enemy comes against you, that you have the authority over all the power of the enemy. Be blessed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Maranatha.